Welcome to all. Today we discuss about hybrid electrical vehicle. This is the contents of our topics like introduction, what is hybrid electrical vehicle, what is hybrid structure, what is components of hybrid electrical vehicle, what is advantages of hybrid electrical vehicle, and what is conclusion. So we discuss one by one point. A hybrid electrical vehicle augments an electrical vehicle with a second source of power referred to as alternative power unit of APU. A hybrid can achieve the cruising range and performance advantages of conventional vehicles with the low noise, low exhaust emissions and energy independence benefits of electrical vehicles. Accordingly, the hybrid concept where the alternative power unit is used as the second source of energy is gaining acceptance and overcoming some of the problems of pure electrical vehicle. What is hybrid electrical vehicle? Hybrid electrical vehicle, a vehicle that has two or more energy conversion technologies combined with one or more energy storage units, is called hybrid electrical vehicle. Two types of hybrid vehicle configurations like parallel hybrids and series hybrids. Parallel hybrid is a fuel tank which supplies gasoline to the engine, set of batteries that supplies power to an electric motor. Both the engine and the electric motor can turn the transmission at the same time, and the transmission then turns at the wheel. This is the diagram. In this diagram, auxiliary power unit, clutch, battery, controller, electric motor, generator, transmission and differential. In parallel, when the APU is off, the parallel hybrid runs like an electrical vehicle. When the APU is on the controller divides such as, this is the all diagram of hybrid electrical vehicles. Okay, this is the all diagram of the electrical vehicle. So when the APU is off, the parallel hybrid runs like an electrical vehicle. When the APU is on, the controller divides the energy between the driver train and batteries. Under acceleration, more power is allocated to the drive run than to the batteries. During periods of idle or low speeds, more power goes to the batteries than the drive train. The batteries also provide additional power to the drive train when the APU is not producing enough, and also the power auxiliary system such as the air conditioner and heater. In series hybrid, similar to an electric vehicle with an board generator, the vehicle runs on the battery power like a pure electric vehicle until the batteries reach a predetermined discharge level. At the point, the APU turns on and begins to recharge the battery. The APU operates until the batteries are charged to a predetermined level. APU never directly powers the vehicles. The length of the time the APU is on depends on the size of the batteries and the APU itself. Since the APU is not directly connected to the driver train, it can be run at optimal operating condition. Hence, the fuel economical is increased and emissions are reduced relative to pure IC engine. In APU, such as auxiliary power unit. In components of hybrid electric vehicle, electric drive motors to provide the power for propulsion, converts electric energy to mechanical energy to drive the hybrid vehicle, direct current motors, alternating current motors. The two possible configurations of electric drive motors in a hybrid vehicle: single electric motor connected to the wheels through a drive train and multiple electric motors, one located at each wheel. Auxiliary power units supply the baseline power required to the vehicle, recharge the battery and the power accessories such as the air conditioner and heater. The APU can consist of a mechanical type engine or a fuel cell, spark ignition engine, compression ignition engines and fuel cells. Generators to convert the mechanical power into electrical power when used in a series hybrid. Energy storage system, peak power required in hybrid vehicle is met by device like batteries, capacitors or a flywheel. Store energy and release it when needed. Regenerative braking, some of the energy is converted into electrical energy and store. Rotational energy of the braking mechanism generates electrical power and stores it in the batteries. in control systems contains two main components, command and power components. Command components manages and processes the driver instructions. Power component chops power flows to control the motor power intake. This is the diagram of start to low speeds. This is the diagram of power control unit, fuel cell, system radiator, fuel cell stack, hydrogen tanks. This is the diagram in which all points are covered. Okay, hydrogen tanks and powertrain radiator. So all these points are there covered. Ultra capacitors are. Fuel cell hybrid vehicle. Electrical vehicles equipped with a fuel cell use hydrogen as a fuel and power the electric batteries when it is depleted. In the 21st century, the auto fuel will be replaced by such regenerative resources as hydrogen, and the power system with traditional internal combustion engine will be replaced by hybrid system, and finally by replaced by fuel cell power system to release multi-resources, electric driving and zero emissions. For the fuel cell, hybrid electric bus develop high pressure and high power battery backup forms of hybrid systems. This is the fuel cell hybrid powertrain system. Fuel cell, this is the structure, FCA, DC, DC-AC, MOT. FC is connected with ESS, is parallel after DC converter battery for the optimization and control of the FCA, and this is the economic selection for the fuel cell vehicle nowadays. This is the fuel cell direct power system. FCA output is directly inputted to DC to AC, and the ESS is connected with the FC's output in parallel after bidirectional DC to DC. FCA outputs power directly into DC to AC. The FCA must be have good dynamic responses to output enough power quickly to meet the vehicle's driving performance requirements, and good voltage maintained performance to avoid the large voltage drop of bus line and the large torque drop of electric motor. On the other side, the FCA must be over large to avoid the possible damage. This is a fuel cell active control system. This is a totally electrical part. The main controller receives the pedal signals from the driver with the values of pedal speed. The driving power required is calculated by lookup table of motor performance map. The target power of fuel cell engine is the sum of the driving power and the SOS regulated power of battery pack. The target current of the DC to DC converter is real time calculated by the target driving power divided by the bus voltage. The air compressor speed control is based on the target power of fuel cell engine. This is a system control strategy, two kinds of control strategy. Conventional fuel cell output power oriented control strategy. Fuel cell output power oriented control strategy based on FC loading and unloading equations. Problems in HEV. To transport and store hydrogen fuel in the vehicle, the cost of producing a powerful fuel cell is high. The size and weight issue as fuel cells power enough to power a car or truck are still rather bulky and heavily. However, through the maturing past, so fuel cells may well prove to be viable option in automobile technology in the not too distant future. Hybrid mileage tips. Drive slower. The aerodynamic drag on the car increases dramatically the faster you drive. For example, the drag force at 70 mph is about double that of 50 mph. Maintain a constant speed. Avoid when you stop your car, the electric motor in the hybrid acts like a generator and takes some of the energy out of the car while slowing it down. If you give the electric motor more time to slow the vehicle, it can recover the more of the energy. If you stop quickly, the brakes on the car will do most of the work of slowing the car down, and the energy will be wasted. This is the advantage of HEV. Use less oil than ICE, emit less CO2 than ICE, fuel efficiency increase, less overall mass, regenerative braking, battery level efficiency, and tax incentives. So, conclusion is, using the concept of hybridization of cars results in better efficiency and also saves a lot of fuel in today's fuel deficit world. A hybrid gives a solution to all problems to some extent. If proper research and development is done in this field, hybrid vehicle promises a practical, efficient, low pollution vehicle for the coming area. One can surely conclude that this concept and the similar ones to follow with even better efficiency and conversion rate are very much on the annuals in today's energy difficult world. So thank you very much, all of you.